If you've been on the internet lately, you would have seen this meme floating around. While most people share this meme to troll, some people genuinely had this question. I got a ton of DMs on Instagram asking me why this is not possible. So let's try and answer that question in this video. And in the process, let's also talk about why the moon is moving away from the earth and why the earth's rotation is slowing down and so the days are getting longer, because the two are related. That's your answer. This clip contains the exact reason why this is not possible. Want me to elaborate? Welcome to scienceisdope, my name is Pranav, and let's take a look at what's happening in the clip. As I'm moving this way, the table I pushed off of is moving the other way. Imagine what would happen if both the objects were tied to each other. After the push, I want to move this way and the table wants to move that way. So which way are we actually gonna move? The answer is neither. The center of mass of the entire system stays in one place. It doesn't move at all. That's exactly what Newton's first law says. A body stays at rest or in uniform motion until and unless an unbalanced external force acts upon it. Right now, this table moved because my pushing force was an external force. But if the two are tied up like this, my push becomes an internal force within the system and cannot move the system. Why is this so? See these two magnets? Watch what happens when they attract each other. This magnet pulls on this magnet, and this magnet also pulls on the other magnet. The same thing happens for this magnet and a piece of metal. The magnet pulls the metal piece towards it, and the metal piece also pulls the magnet towards it. And that is Newton's third law. Every action has an equal and opposite reaction. And you can see why they're equal and opposite, because the same force moves the heavier object less in one direction and the lighter object more in the other direction. And their center of mass, or the average position of both the masses, or the position of the system, remained in the same place. In fact, if I give you the masses of both these objects, you can analyze the video frame by frame and make sure their center of mass is always in the same position. Now let's come back to this meme. After what I've told you, you will instantly recognize what's wrong with this picture. If the magnet is gonna pull the metal, then the metal will also pull the magnet with an equal and opposite force, meaning the center of mass of the system will remain in the same place. In other words, it won't move. If you want to move the system, then you need an external force, or the magnet needs to be attached to something else. This here is possible because the force that's pulling the system is external to the system and hence moves the system. The same can be said about pushing forces as well. If two objects that are part of the same system push each other, their average position or the system center of mass is not gonna move. You can see the same issue with more of these videos. This guy is not moving because the leaf blower is blowing his umbrella. That's an internal force. It can't move the system. So he was probably pushed by someone before the camera started rolling. Or maybe there's some wind here that can act as an external force pushing him. In this video, this man is applying an internal force to move the system and hence is doing nothing. The vehicle is moving only because of a push from these men. They're pushing against the ground and their force is therefore external. Remember, you need an external force to move something, not an internal one like this. Throughout all this, I've looked at this only from the perspective of Newton's laws. But there's one more reason why you can say that this is impossible. And if you want to know how this relates to the moon slowly moving away, then you need to understand. Remember this clip? See what happens here. This mass m1 moving with the speed v1 in this direction, and this mass m2 moving with the speed v2 in this direction, if you multiply them, they will always be equal and opposite. And you can calculate and check this. All you need is a weighing scale and a measuring tape and a stopwatch. This quantity is what we call momentum. And this is always true provided there is no external force acting on the system. In the absence of an external force, the total momentum of a system remains conserved. This is called the law of conservation of momentum. What does that mean? If I want to gain momentum, I have to make something else lose momentum or gain momentum in the opposite direction. Okay, too complicated, Pranav, make it simple. If I want to move, then I have to push against something else. If I'm walking, then I'm pushing the ground backwards with my feet, and the friction between my feet and the ground is what's pushing me forward. If this friction was not there, something like this would happen. Now, if we look at this in terms of momentum, then whatever momentum I'm gaining, the earth, the whole earth is gaining an equal but opposite momentum. But we never notice this motion, because the earth moves less than a billionth of the width of a hydrogen atom. Pretty much zero motion. Now here's a question for you. If I'm pushing myself off a wall like this, then I'm gaining momentum in this direction. Why is the wall not gaining an opposite momentum? If you know the answer, let me know it down in the comments, or you can wait till the end of this video and I'll give you the answer. Okay, back to the meme. How do you analyze this using conservation of momentum? Okay, there is no external force in the system, so momentum is conserved. If you want to give this car momentum this way using the magnet, then the magnet has to gain an equal and opposite momentum this way, so the center mass of the system remains in the same place. In other words, it doesn't move. Let's say there's no friction. Even if something like this happens, remember how I showed you the two magnets attract each other and the center of mass remains in the same place? That's exactly what would happen. The car isn't going anywhere because of this, and I'm sorry if I burst your dreams of finding a solution for the fuel price hike. If you want to make it move somehow, then you have to give it some other force that's external to the system that can move the entire thing. That's what an engine does. It makes the wheel push the ground backwards, and the friction between the wheels and the ground pushes the car forwards because it's external to the system. Okay, so what's the takeaway for this entire section? If there's no external forces, then the momentum of the system remains conserved. Okay, now we're set to answer the question, why is the moon moving away? Look at how this ice skater is spinning faster as he brings his arms in and slower as he spreads them back out. What exactly could be happening here? If this is the axis around which he is rotating, then his average distance or his average spread around this axis is some length r. And when he brings his arms in, basically that r is decreasing, but simultaneously his velocity of spin is going up. As the r is going down, the v is going up. You'll see that if you take the product of both these quantities, that will remain constant. You can multiply another quantity which is already constant, like the mass of the system, and their product will once again remain constant. You can also write this as m1 v1 r1 equals m1 v2 r2, and I'm using the same m1 on both sides because the mass of the person doesn't really change before and after, only v and r change. And this quantity which remains the same before and after is called angular momentum. And what I've just shown you is something called the law of conservation of angular momentum. This at least is a highly oversimplified version. You physics people, don't bombard me in the comments saying this isn't precise enough. Okay, the law of conservation of angular momentum is similar to the law of conservation of linear momentum. The only difference is this is for rotation and this is for linear motion. This says that in the absence of a net external force, the linear momentum of a system remains conserved. And this says that in the absence of a net external torque, the angular momentum of a system remains conserved. And a torque is nothing but a spinning force, or a force that causes a spin. Okay, that was a lot of physics, and now finally we're ready to answer the question, why is the moon slowly moving away from us? See, the earth takes 24 hours to spin on its axis. We call that a day. There are many factors which affect this rotation, like the tides in the oceans and the gravitational interaction the earth has with the sun and the other planets. But in effect, this means the rotation of the earth is slowing down at a rate of about 2 milliseconds every century, which is about the same rate as me getting out of bed in the morning. And because of the slowing of spin, the earth's angular momentum is going down, and so because of this equation, something else in the system has to gain angular momentum to compensate for that. The system, or whatever spinning or rotating or revolving around this axis, has to obey the law of conservation of momentum, because there is no net external force, no net external spinning force. And so what's gonna gain that angular momentum? The moon. The earth and the moon form a system that's going around a common axis, and as the earth's spin slows down, the moon slowly moves away from us at a rate of 4 centimeters per year. And as it moves away, it's increasing its average distance from this axis, increasing the distance from us. thereby slowly gaining angular momentum and thus keeping the system in rotational equilibrium. Who would have thought that one meme would help us learn so much? So the question was, if I push off this wall, if I gain momentum this way, shouldn't the wall gain an equal and opposite momentum that way? Why doesn't that happen? You can answer this question in two ways. See, if you're considering a system of you and the wall, then the law of conservation of momentum doesn't apply here because there's going to be other external forces. The wall is attached to the floor and the ceiling, right? So those are external forces restricting its motion. The other answer is when you consider not just you and the wall, but you extend your system to the entire building. So that means if you move, then the building should move the other way, but that doesn't happen. The building is fixed to the earth. So it's like the building and the earth are one system. So if you move in one direction, then the whole earth has to move in the other direction. And as we've seen with the walking example, that's pretty much zero motion. That's the answer to the question. Hope you enjoyed watching. I'll see you in the next one. Till then, remember, science is dope.